किसी भी देश की तरक्की में उद्यमियों का अहम योगदान होता है। ये अपने हौसले और नए इनोवेशन से कारोबार को नई ऊंचाइयों पर ले जाते हैं। इनकी मेहनत से देश की अर्थव्यवस्था का पहिया आगे बढ़ता है, इसलिए इन हीरोज को सम्मानित करना जरूरी है, क्योंकि इनकी सफलता की कहानी दूसरों के लिए प्रेरणा बनती है। देश के इन असली हीरोज को सम्मानित करने के लिए एंटरप्रेन्योर 2018 का आयोजन किया गया। मकसद था बिजनेस में नए इनोवेशंस कर रहे चेहरों को सम्मानित करना और उनकी मेहनत को नई पहचान देना। भारत सरकार के मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री सीआर चौधरी भी इस कार्यक्रम का हिस्सा बने। यहाँ बिजनेस में आ रहे बदलाव और चुनौतियों पर एक खास सेशन भी हुआ। इसमें कारोबार के क्षेत्र में सफलता प्राप्त करने के लिए प्लानिंग और तैयारियों के महत्व पर चर्चा हुई। यहाँ इंडस्ट्री के अलग अलग क्षेत्र के दिग्गजों ने हिस्सा लिया। ओयो रूम्स के फाउंडर एंड सीईओ रितेश अगरवाल और क्रॉन सिस्टम्स के सीईओ एंड को फाउंडर तुषार छाबड़ा की मोटिवेशनल स्पीच से एंटरप्रेन्योर्स को दूसरों से हटकर अपनी अलग राह बनाने की प्रेरणा मिली। एंटरप्रेन्योर 2018 के दूसरे हिस्से में उन चेहरों को सम्मानित किया गया जिन्होंने अपनी मेहनत से कारोबार के क्षेत्र में कामयाबी की नई राह तलाशी है। कार्यक्रम के 8वें एडिशन की शुरुआत फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया की एडिटर इन चीफ रितु मारिया की मोटिवेशनल स्पीच से हुई।
वेरी वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू फेलो एंटरप्रेन्योर्स, बिजनेस ओनर्स, एसएमई ओनर्स हु आर प्रेजेंट ओवर हियर टुडे टू जॉइन अस फॉर एंटरप्रेन्योर 2018। दिस इज द 8th ईयर ऑफ दिस इवेंट एंड इंसिडेंटली इन 2018 वी हैव इट, सो व्हेन वी वर थिंकिंग व्हाट शुड बी द थीम ऑफ द शो, वी थॉट इट वाज मोस्ट बेफिटिंग टू एक्चुअली have the theme which is the infinity sign that you see right there, because we feel that today entrepreneurs don't build businesses for some number that they want to achieve in the near future. They want to build businesses for scale. They want to build businesses which have infinite growth. So we thought in the 8th year in 2018, entrepreneurs should be fittingly be themed as a year of infinite growth, and how is it that we're going to achieve that infinite growth is really what counts. Thank you very much for joining us.
इसके बाद भारत सरकार में मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री सीआर चौधरी ने लोगों के सामने अपने विचार रखे। उन्होंने स्टार्टअप योजना से छोटे शहरों के लोगों को हुए फायदे के बारे में भी विस्तार से बताया।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट द होल एंटरप्रेन्योर्स इंडिया मीडिया ग्रुप for organize this 8th edition of the Entrepreneur Convention. Really, it's a very great job. Presently, India requires such type of convention, such type of seminars, such type of conferences, because industrial, we are now moving or we are passing through the fourth industrial revolution, that is totally robotic and technological. The industry requires the latest technology and the young startup and young investor, they want to do something. I hope in these 2 days you people will discuss a lot. What problems you are facing, what solution you want, what help you want from the government. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Ab mauka tha ek khas panel discussion ka. Topic tha From Ideas to Series A. Isme karobar ke kshetra mein safalta prapt karne ke liye planning aur taiyariyon ke mahatv par charcha ki gayi.
This particular session that we are going to be featuring today is about from moving from ideas to Series A funding and what it involves. Let me start with a question to Akshay. Startup has to keep scaling up, right? So how do investors view this upscaling and what are they looking for?
I think typically, I would say like Series A funding is actually the most difficult stage to actually raise at, right? Because typically at an angel or seed, it's really on the overall idea as well as the team on which the investor is betting on. When it comes to Series A, you have to start showing some validation. I think that typically ends up being a little bit of a, it's a little bit sticky for the entrepreneur to know what you know, what validation are you supposed to be going to investors at? And so I think the way I think about that is, one is, depending on the space the entrepreneur has chosen, have they figured out exactly what are the different levers, right, around the business? I like to look at, just some evidence of customer love at a very early stage. It may not be for every customer the startup is touching, but at least, you'll typically see high engagement with, a segment or a sub-segment, right? And I think that's very powerful to then build upon.
So let's ask Pushkar, right? So we have this sort of an expectation that Akshay has voiced. How would you manage an investor expectation?
I think when it comes to sort of raising a Series A, I think one of the most important things, which at least I believe, is that you have to have some evidence of sort of product market fit, right? Essentially, you have to have a model which you believe can scale up, and there's a market opportunity which exists for you to sort of scale up the business, right? And I think as long as you have some evidence of showing that, right, whether it's through sort of traction in numbers, whether your understanding of your customer, I think those are the things which sort of help you when you're positioning your company for an institutional raise. The second thing is that, I think as you start engaging with investors, very important to really make them part of your journey, whether it's by involving them in certain critical business decisions, whether it's involving them in critical hires. What starts to happen is you start sort of building a partnership, and then nothing is really a shock because they are as much part of the journey as sort of you are. I think we've found sort of doing these things quite effective when it comes to managing investor expectations.
Okay. Let's ask Neerav, what is your experience in this process of continuously looking at product market fit?
I think the greatest feedback that you get is from your customer, right? We as entrepreneurs have these visions about where we see the product fitting and how it'll make a difference to the world at large. But ultimately, it's the customer who kind of gives you feedback. And if you're listening, in our experience, if we listen as an organization, and it's just not the leadership team, but the entire organization is listening, the product evolves perfectly. But I think that's where most businesses fail, right? You'd have the sales guy interested in selling the product. You'd have, the product guy interested in using the best technology out there and things like that. But very few people focus on listening to what the customer really wants. So I think that's the key in my experience and in my opinion.
Okay. And I think this is an excellent point to bring Manish in. How did you decide to do what you're doing?
We're three friends quite interested in technology, data, market segmentation. And when somebody kind of throws you some huge numbers, you would be like kids, who get very excited across to see what can we do in the market. So, I remember, I think, where we started across is when we saw the possibility of the numbers whom we can impact, we started with a very simple assumption that, Relia 3, we focus on train travel, what we call across as the long distance travel marketplace, and about 30 million people travel every single day. So our initial thought process was that, if we can do anything, because of which these people will carry us as part of the journey, we'll figure out something. That was the starting point. So let's figure out how to be in their hands, how do we become part of the journey. And that's how we started, because the number was huge. The ceiling was quite high. It was a completely untapped market because of the historical reasons.
Thanks, gentlemen, for all your involvement. I hope this session has been useful for all of you.
पैनल डिस्कशन के बाद ओयो रूम्स के फाउंडर एंड सीईओ और डायनामिक यंग एंटरप्रेन्योर रितेश अग्रवाल ने अपनी सफलता के राज बताए और कारोबारियों को सफल बिजनेस करने के तरीके बताए।
वेरी एक्साइटेड टू बी हियर, थैंक यू एंटरप्रेन्योर फॉर हैविंग मी हियर। काफी लोग सोचते हैं कि ओयो इज अ होटल चेन, ओयो वाज स्टार्टेड टू बी एन एसेट लाइट इंटरनेट बेस्ड होटल कंपनी एंड सो ऑन। व्हाट आई ट्राई टू रिमाइंड एवरीवन अराउंड आवरसेल्व्स is that our mission is very straightforward. We want to create great quality living spaces. It doesn't matter how it happens. It happens in an asset light way, asset heavy way. It doesn't really matter until we are creating great quality living spaces. So that's a single mission with, of course, a bunch of model innovations that has made us over the last 4.5 years the largest hotel chain in South Asia. In 4.5 years now, we manage close to 105,000 rooms across South Asia, primarily out of India and Nepal. And of course, now we operate across multiple markets that we will talk later about. But there has to be something more than just a mission and model innovation that enables us this. If you have 1,500 rupees in your pocket, this is the same hotel, by the way, would you stay in the hotel on the left or would you stay on the hotel on the right? The answer is pretty straightforward. You're going to stay at the hotel on the right. That is what OYO does. We believe if you create a great product, customers will show up right outside your door, because at the end of the day, if you have 1,500 to 2,000 rupees in your pocket, you're always going to come to the product that we renovate into rather than the product that existed earlier. Thank you so much, guys. It's been great fun. Really appreciate all the hearing.
Yes Bank ke Group President Nikhil Sahani ki speech se karobariyon ko business mein aage badhne ki prerna mili.
What I have been asked to speak about is the Corporate Government Connect. We have, you know, institutionalized a program called Yes Scale. Now, this is a program where we are providing entrepreneurs a platform to work on test cases which can then further get commercialized. So we call it Yes Scale. S stands for smart cities and smart city solutions. C stands for clean tech. A for agri tech. L for life sciences tech. And E for edutech. And we have, you know, for example, we have tied up with 6 to 7 smart cities which have been identified by the Government of India and got test cases from IT majors, and we are getting startups to participate in this. I think that is something significant that we are doing as an institution to promote the cause of startups.
Ek aur young entrepreneur Tushar Chhabra, CEO and co-founder Cron Systems ke session mein कारोबारियों को बिजनेस की बारीकियों को समझने का मौका मिला.
Indian ecosystem is evolving very quickly, but we lack one thing, and that is building products. We are now suddenly focusing on building technology or replicating technology, but somewhere we have lost the path on understanding what does the end customer want. How can we build companies that can go global, that can scale globally, if we do not build products that solve the problem? How can technology be the only initiator in going to the customer? New startups coming up in the meetups, they're building the best drones in the world, and they say, you know what, we don't know who'll buy us. And I said, why do you want to start a business or start building a product with the mindset of who will buy us? So focus here. Do not start with the simple ideology of who will invest in me, why will somebody invest in me, why and who will acquire me 5 years down the line. Rather, start with the ideology, how can I build the best product? How can I make it global? How can I make a dent in industry? What is my revenue model? How can I become a profitable organization? If you answer this, the right partners, the right people will find you themselves. You will not have to go out hunting for those people. That's all from my side. Thank you so much for giving me an opportunity to speak today. Thank you.
अब बारी थी उन हस्तियों को सम्मानित करने की जो दिन रात मेहनत कर अपने कारोबार को नए मुकाम पर ले जाकर सफलता की मिसाल कायम कर रही हैं.
Family Entrepreneur of the Year goes to Mr. Himanshu Gupta, Managing Director, S. Chand & Company Limited. Tech Startup of the Year, Mr. V. Raman Kumar, Founder and Chairman, Cache. Innovative Startup of the Year. And this one goes to Mr. Vikram Kumar, CEO and founder, Let's Track Humanizing Technology. Women Entrepreneur of the Year, Nari Shakti rocks. And it goes to MD and Creative Head, GSL Lifestyle, Miss Deepika Jindal. The next winner for tonight, Social Entrepreneur of the Year, and it goes to Dr. Rajendra Kumar Joshi, founder, RUJ Group of Companies and BSDU. Entrepreneur of the Year, Consumer Business, Mr. Nikhil Mohan, Director, Mohan Clothing Company, Private Limited, Blackberries. Entrepreneur of the Year, Healthcare Services. And it goes to Mr. Vivek Srivastav, Chief Executive Officer and Co-Founder, Healthcare at Home. Entrepreneur of the Year in Trading Business, Wholesaler or CNF, Mr. Rahul Ara, Founder, Designer and Deliver. Entrepreneur of the Year in Service Business Financial, Mr. Naveen Kukreja, CEO and Co-Founder, PaisaBazaar.com.
I'm myself an entrepreneur in the early days, so very hard for me to give advice to entrepreneurs. You know, exactly 4 years back, I was also in a conference like this, trying to find a potential partner, trying to make sure that we can get an investor whom I can raise some capital from. But eventually, if you keep working hard, there is light at the end of the tunnel. So I think I would say perseverance is a very important trait.
Through this event of Entrepreneur, I think the important thing is to know that age is not a bar to start following your passion. I think you can be an entrepreneur at any age. The idea is just to just start doing something. If you have a passion, follow it. Don't not follow it because you think you're very old, because I don't think age is a limitation. Aapka jabhi bhi man, jab aapke man mein kuch aata hai, aapko kar lena chahiye.
It's a great platform. I think it's a platform which helps people understand what other entrepreneurs are doing, and you know, take learnings from those people across, and utilize those learnings in their own you know, businesses.
Very good platform for new entrepreneurs, for new startups. They can learn so many things from the coming entrepreneurs, the budding entrepreneurs which are already there. Lot many entrepreneurs are coming and sharing their experience, sharing their challenges, what the challenges they were facing from the start, and now what they are facing, and all the situations that they know about the company and how it is growing. And so there are lot many things that to learn. You can learn from here.
When we launched, we had 500 other companies working on the similar tracking solutions. But what we have done is we've taken the card security to the next level. And the response we have received and the appreciation we are receiving today from entrepreneur.com or other organizations which have awarded, it's a testimony of how passionate, how good, and how brilliant we are in what we are doing. And I would just like to say, watch this space. We are here, and we are here to conquer.
We feel like we've conquered vehicle security element. Now we're moving big time into home automation. We want to bring a system that's simple and easy to India and the world, that can help people be safer at home, save money at home, and live in a simpler way and a more comforted way in their own home.
For this award, I'm really very thankful for the Entrepreneur magazine, because he selected us and recognized our work, what we are doing in India. This is the great achievement of us also, and we are very thankful to the Entrepreneur. And for the young people, I want to say that let's have some vision and then work hard to achieve that vision. That is our aim.
Our aim is to become Dr. Josh's dreams true, bring the dual education system to India. And for this, we have our university, BSDU, and to showcase what you can do with well-trained people, we started to build a manufacturing unit, RS India.
I'm delighted to accept the Tech Startup of the Year award on behalf of my entire team, a team of over 100 people that have worked incessantly over the last 2 years to make this into a successful startup. I'm also delighted to tell that we now have given over 200,000 loans using our proprietary social loan quotient algorithm, which we recently launched to the public. So it is visible, and the social loan quotient is the first alternate credit rating system using alternate data points, which conventional credit rating systems do not use, and we thereby hope to bring over 100 million people into the credit system over the next few years.
So I'm very happy and excited to win this award, and I'm very thankful to Entrepreneur India magazine that they have given me this award. Primarily, Estran Group has been there in the business for the last 80 years, and we have been disrupting the industry in the last 5-6 years, mainly because of getting into more acquisition and doing acquisition in the regional publishing, in the print side, and the digital side, we are doing many more things like doing VRX, a virtual reality experience, giving a lot of digital enabled content with the books, and a lot other things that we're trying to do to make sure that we are always one step ahead of the competition.